Optics 2022 lets us work with alpha and masks in Photoshop in a brand new way. In this short video, I'm going to show you some of the standard workflows that we can use to move layer masks back and forth between Adobe Photoshop and Boris FX Optics. And we're going to start here with our first image. And I've got two layers. I've got the girl layer at the top, and I've got my background at the bottom here. And I'm going to use Easy Mask in Optics to create a mask for this layer. And I'm just going to add a layer mask down at the bottom here. Now, if I was doing any other sort of filtering on this, I would convert this into a smart object. But here I just want to generate up a mask. We'll see the smart object workflow in the next example. So with the color thumbnail selected, I'm going to go to Filter, Optics 2022. It's going to ask me if I want to apply my previous mask and filters, and I just say no. And because I just want to create a mask, I can ignore all of the effects down at the bottom. I'll just come up to the top left-hand corner, go Add Mask, Easy Mask. And if you'd like to learn more about Easy Masks, then we do have a full video about those. And I'm just going to left-click to draw a green area around the parts that I want to keep in. So just do a few little strokes here. And I'll right-click to do red strokes around the areas that I want to keep out. And I'll hit the process cog up the top, or the Enter key, and that will generate up our mask. Let's turn off our overlays and come over to the top to show our mask up here, or hit M. And here's the mask that it generated, looking pretty good, I think. Got some really nice hair detail, still maintained. So let's take this back out into Photoshop. Now, if I would just hit apply down in the bottom right now, nothing would happen. So I have to come up to my layers and I'm going to click the export masks button. So with this selected, it's going to take out the mask from this particular layer. So now if I hit apply on this one, you can see it's come in with a new updated layer mask. So this is an actual Photoshop layer mask. If we're just alt click on that, you can see layer mask there. And so we can update this just like we could do any other Photoshop layer mask. So for example, if I needed just to add a little bit more into the hand down here, I can do just that. Or I can even use the Photoshop's own select and mask tool to come in and further refine this mask. But I don't think we're getting much better results there, so I'll just cancel on that one. One last thing to note is that even though we haven't done this to a smart object, we can still come in and further refine this if we need to. But only if Optics was the last thing we applied. So let's get rid of our layer mask. Let's just delete that again. I'll add the new layer mask in and come back into Optics. And I can apply previous masks and filters. I'll just say yes. So Optics has just applied the previous settings that we were working with. So we can come in and further refine our mask. Like so. And I've still got my export mask button turned on, so I apply that, and that will come in and bring in our updated mask there. And this workflow is basically the same, even if we protected this layer inside a smart object, the alpha would come through, but we wouldn't see a layer mask immediately. Now, it's also worth pointing out that in Optics, Easy Mask is being processed at the viewer resolution. So in this case, up the top, 2K. If I set this to full resolution now, it's going to ask to regenerate the masks at the current resolution. And I can just hit yes, and it will go along and just reprocess out that mask at full res. And check out what happens when I take this down to a lower res, 2K or 1K. Because we've processed out the Easy Mask at the full resolution, it's not going to want to process this out at any lower resolution at all. The change in the image we're seeing here is just because we're seeing fewer pixels, not because the mask is changing. If I hit apply, Easy Mask is going to be taken out at the resolution that we have set in the viewer. So if I've only processed out my Easy Mask in 2K or 1K, then the resulting mask is going to be upscaled when we're back into Photoshop. So unless we have our viewer set to full at least once to process out the Easy Mask at full, we're not going to be getting the full quality Easy Mask out into Photoshop. Now, if we take a look at our second example, sometimes we might want to go in the other direction. And let's work non-destructively here. So I'm going to make a copy of my background here. I'm going to right click and I will convert this into a smart object. I will call this one Optics. There we go. And I'm just going to use Photoshop's object selection tool. And I'm going to select my subject here. And this should find, yeah, there we go. This should find a pretty decent mask of the woman at the front. I'll create a layer mask there. Yeah, that's looking all right. And in Photoshop, I can just shift select on the layer mask just to disable it. So even though we can't see this mask now, we can still use this when we come into Optics. So I'm just going to select the color part of the layer, come into my filters and go and apply Optics again. I don't want to apply my previous masks. As we can see here, Optics has still brought in our layer mask from Photoshop. So we have that on our original layer there as a layer mask. And I can disable that here. Now, what you might notice is that even though we disabled the layer mask on the original image, we're still not getting the entire image back. Now, the reason for that is that if we come up to the top of the viewer here, we're previewing this over black. We can preview it over gray, over white, checkerboard, or we can do RGB straight, which is showing us just the color pixels without any thought of the alpha channel. But let's bring the viewer back to preview over black, and let's work further with this mask. I'm just going to add an effect to bring everything back. And the effect we need is S channel switcher. And there's a little preset that I've got down here called RGB A white. And all this is setting my parameters over here to red is the red channel, green is the green channel, blue is the blue channel, and alpha is one, which means we're seeing the complete image. We've got full alpha back again. So now we can see our entire image. I can start adding other effects in here. So if I come in, we'll do something with particle illusion, I think. We'll just add in the default particle, which is like this gate thing here. Lovely. And it's very easy to recycle masks between layers in Optics. So all I'm going to do is grab this mask that we have from our original up to this new layer. If I click on it, I can do things like invert it. I can also change the opacity of it as well, but we'll keep that opacity at 100%. So that's looking pretty good. And if I wanted to, I could even build on this using Optics' own masking system. So again, I'll come into Easy Mask. I'll do right clicks to create red areas here, here, and here. Green to go in around about there. And let's see what we get out of this one. So let's process this out. Hit M. And this looks like it's doing something, but it's not quite doing what we need it to do. So all we need to do is go up to the top here and change the way that these masks are blended together. I will multiply these masks so we get sort of a combination of these two. That's looking a lot nicer. Now, because we're taking this out as a complete image, I don't need to have any of these other buttons selected because we don't want to take out the layer masks here. So I'll just hit apply. And then when we come back into Photoshop, we see the image that we've taken out from Optics. And because we're working non-destructively, I can always just double click on my Optics Smart Filter and go back and finish this shot. Now, there are also times where you want to use Optics with text layers. So I'll come in, I'll add some text and convert this text to a smart object, and we will apply Optics again. And we can see that Optics has brought in this text clip with a alpha channel as well. So if I come to render and we'll choose something like clouds, maybe. Just some of the clouds, I'll choose one of the presets and then we'll just change the colors of this up. I don't know quite what I'm going for right now, but you know, ooh, that's something. And let's just see what happens if I hit apply here. Optics brings this back and it's maintained the original alpha channel. And I want to show you what happens when we use one of the other filters, like some of the other render filters, something like Luna here. If I hit A to show the alpha channel, it will actually generate up a new alpha channel. So if I choose something like grunge, and we'll do Art Attack, there we go. So if I do something like grunge and I hit A, you can see that we've got a brand new alpha channel on here. So if we've got a brand new alpha channel being created and we only want the effect to go in the text, we just drag the text mask up here. And so even though this looks a bit weird, so let's hit apply. If I don't do anything else here now, you can see that it's brought in all this stuff with that new alpha channel. Probably don't want that. We want to confine it to the text. Now, when the export mask icon is not selected, it's the processed filter alpha that's sent back to Photoshop. If we have the export mask icon selected, we override this behavior. And so it just takes out that mask, even if that alpha is full. What do I need to do? Well, we've seen this before. I just have to tell Optics to output this layer mask back to Photoshop. So with that turned on and I hit apply, we come in and we get our grunge applied just to the text. In this final example, I want to show you how to use some of the light effects, but use them as part of a composite instead. So let's do what we've done before. I'm going to make a copy of my background layer. I'm going to convert that to a smart object. I'll call this one lens flare, because guess what we're going to be doing on this. All right. And let's go into Optics 2022. And I won't apply the previous filters, but I will come into my light category and I will apply a lens flare. And we have lots of flares to choose from here. Find something that's a little bit yellow still. Oh, there we go. It's not me. There we go. That's pretty good. Place that there. Let's change the pivot point up a little bit. So at the moment, if I took this out, I'd be taking out the entire image. I wouldn't be taking out just the flare element. Now, some effects do have controls about how they're composited together. For example, flare has under combine flare only. And this will take out the flare with an alpha channel. So instead of taking out an image where we have the alpha channel, I'm going to add another layer in here. I'm going to go to color and I'm going to make a solid color. And I want it solid black. And I'm going to bring that underneath the lens flare. So if we come back into the lens flare layer, you still see it's still giving me the alpha channel. So I'm going to change my combine mode back to screen. So this is just going to screen it onto black. So it's exactly the same image as we had previously, but it's now got a full alpha channel. So if I hit apply on that, and that will come back looking like this. So we can come in and screen this over. And at that point, I can add my own layer mask into this and then paint my flare back in just as I need it to. And that's how we can deal with effects that generate up their own alpha channels. So in this tutorial, we've seen many different ways of how we can deal with getting the back and forth between Optics and Photoshop, and also between Photoshop and Optics. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'll see you in another Optics tutorial very soon. If you'd like to learn more about Optics, download a free trial, or watch any of our other Optics tutorials, then just head on over to borisfx.com.